Hello, Mr. Nygren here. So, I'm gonna show you how to install Warcraft World War version 2.2 with the M2TV Medieval 2 Engine Overhaul Project Tool. M2TWEOP tool. Okay, so we'll first go to this search to modbay.com. Also, by the way, before you do anything, go to Google, search for WinRAR. You need this program to unrare rare archives. It's the best one. You need the latest version. Click on the first option that arrives when you search for WinRAR. WinRAR download free and support WinRAR. Click there and download the tool. Click here to download and install it anywhere on your computer, and then all the archives or files using this archive format will look like this. This is the symbol of WinRAR. Okay, so in essence, when you have downloaded a full a mod, for example, you will have the mod in a archive with this symbol. So you just double click on the mod. It will be VTV, WVTV in big letters, and then you will have the mod inside here. You can just drag it out with your mouse. You can also use the buttons. I never do that. So for example, you drag it to the mods folder of the Medieval 2 Total War game from this folder by just dragging it with the mouse. Okay, and it will take a while until it finishes. When you start a when you click on a rare archive, you can also right click on it and extract the archive with these buttons, but then you will create a folder, and it's the folder inside of the created folder that you need. So for example, you would get a WVTV folder here, a VTV folder, and then you click on it, and then you will find another folder inside of it named VTV, and it's that one you need to drag to the mods folder. Okay, and when you double click on this file, any file with the WinRAR archive symbol, you will get this to show up asking you to buy something. You don't need to buy anything, you can just deselect that. Sometimes it's a bigger splash screen, and just exit that screen, because this program is free to use. You don't need to pay anything. Okay, so go to Medieval 2, you go to modbay.com, and then you search for Medieval 2, the game. You need to use the I letters here, two I letters for Medieval 2. Then you find the game, click on it, and then on mods. And then in this area here, you'll find Warcraft World War. It's at the bottom currently. That will change, okay, from time to time. So it's the top 20 mods from Medieval 2 that are shown there. If it's not there, it will be in the other area, in this area. But it depends on when it was last updated. You will find it here, but it might have been moved further down if it's been if it's not been updated in a while. Okay. So we are on the main page of Warcraft World War, where you can read the article. You can click on it to get even more text, but otherwise you can read most of it on the start page. Here we have the instructions on how to install the mod using the Engine Overhaul Project tool, and instructions on other stuff as well, and you have the new features of the latest 2.2 version of Warcraft World War. And further down, you can find the files list. You can also find the most important files in the article. For example, we have the 4GB patch, which is required for mods on Medieval 2. Most mods require that, like Elder Scrolls Total War, Third Age Total War, Warhammer Beginning of the End Times, Hyrule Total War, Warcraft Total War, and other mods, Game of Thrones Total War Enhanced, Fire and Blood, etc. Okay, they all need this this patch to be applied on the .exe files of your game. Otherwise, they don't the game won't work. But you don't need it if you have used it already on the Medieval 2.exe file and the Kingdoms.exe file to get another mod to run. If you have done it for another mod, you don't need to do it again for this mod. But if you haven't done it for another mod, then you need to, you know, download it and use it on your Medieval 2.exe and Kingdoms.exe. Okay, here's the main mod file. You can click here to get to the download page. Okay, and here are some instructions of the latest version. info. Okay, you can go down to this area. Otherwise, you have three files. The 4 GB patch I just talked about. Click there and you can download it. So the 4 GB patch. We can go to mods and in this case, just to show the mod, we have Hyrule to the War with the 4 GB patch already there. Large address aware is pretty much the same type of patch. It's two different versions of similar patch. I believe the 4 GB patch enables older games like Medieval Total War to make use of more RAM memory than use 2 GB. So the original Medieval Total War game, as well as many other old games from released in 2006, 2007, 2005, etc., they are limited to just 2 GB of RAM. So even if you have a computer with 8 GB of RAM, or 4 GB of RAM, or 16 GB of RAM, or 32 GB of RAM, the games would only be able to read 2 GB. And this program, the 4 GB patch, enables the .exe of the game to be able to make use of more than 2 GB of RAM. It increases it from 2 to 4. And the large address aware probably does the same thing. Okay, so it's just two different tools doing the same thing. So instead of Medieval 2 being able to read 2 GB of RAM memory, it will instead be able to read 4 GB of RAM memory. So you right click on this, run as an administrator, and then you search for the mods.exe file that you find in Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Medieval Total War, Mods. And here you have the mods. They should be located in the mods folder. But you, I forgot, it's not the mod files, it's the exe files of the game. So in Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Medieval Total War, if you use the Steam version, you will have the Medieval2.exe and the Kingdoms.exe here. If you have just installed the game, or if you haven't used mods before for the Steam version, then you may not have the Kingdoms.exe file. Because unlike in the CD version, where you would buy Medieval Total War and get the Medieval2.exe, and then you buy the Kingdoms expansion and get the Kingdoms.exe, unlike in the CD version, the Steam version came with all of the, with both the original game and the expansion as one single exe, so you only have the Medieval2.exe. So what you need to do is, you need to go to Steam, Steam Apps Common, Medieval Total War, then you need to go to the Medieval2.exe, right click on it, and then create a copy. So you need to copy the file, click on copy, and then paste it here. And then you will rename the copied file to Kingdoms. And after that you have Medieval2.exe and Kingdoms.exe for Steam as well. This is required for many mods to start on Steam. And then you need to, when you use the tool, the 4 GB patch, you will click on the Medieval2.exe, open, and then you will do the same to the Kingdoms.exe. So you click on this and open, and it will patch, executable successfully patched, and then another file, you click there, and then you do the same to the kingdoms.exe file. After that, they should be patched. If there is any problems making the patch not work for you and you get an error message, then that might be because you have an old computer that doesn't have 4 GB of RAM memory. You need at minimum 4 GB of RAM memory, otherwise the 4 GB patch won't work, because it enables your computer, it enables the game to make use of 4 GB RAM out of the RAM memory of your computer. If you have less than 4 GB of RAM memory, then it won't work. So you need 4 GB of RAM memory or more for the patch to work. And the mods won't work without the patch, because unlike the old game released in 2006 and its expansion released in 2007, the mods use much better models, much better terrain, much better everything. So many mods add new models, new settlements, new terrain, new battlefields, new pictures, new videos. Everything is enhanced, new gameplay, and if you do not have the 4GB patch applied, then the game will crash a lot because it can't handle all the new stuff with just 2GB of RAM memory. But with the 4GB patch, it can finally make use of twice as much memory, which means it will not crash as much because it is now more, what should I say, suited to handle the better models and such. And most mods today, like Third Age, Warhammer, Elder Scrolls, Game of Thrones, etc., Warcraft and Hyrule, they need the patch. Otherwise they will crash when you try to start a campaign, or in the campaign, or in battle, etc. So yeah, and if your computer is too weak for that, if the computer doesn't have 4GB of RAM memory, and has 3GB or something, then you're out of luck, you'll need a new computer. Okay, because the mods are more demanding than the old game. It's like an updated version of the old game, using much more resource demanding models and such. Okay, and probably more scripts and more features too. Okay, so now you know how to use the 4GB patch. And you go back to Hyrule. And 4GB patch, there is also the large address aware. You click on run as administrator. And then you click on this browse button and you browse to your Medieval Total War folder. And then patch the same files. So for example, Medieval Total War. And then you make sure this is checked and then you click save. I won't do it now, but you need to do that on both files. And that's an alternative to using the 4GB patch. Maybe it will work if the other one doesn't. If not, you're out of luck. Okay. And then, as for Warcraft Total War, you place it inside, with the Steam version, you place it inside of Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Medieval Total War, Mods, and with the CD, it's inside of whatever directory, whatever hard drive you have installed Medieval 2 on. For me it's D, and then you never have Medieval Total War installed in program files x86. You need to move it out, create a folder named games like I have done, and place Medieval 2 there. So we have Sega, place the Sega folder here with the CD, and then Medieval 2 Total War is inside of Sega folder, and then inside of the Medieval Total War folder we have the mods folder. So with the CD you still need to use the 4GB patch and the large address aware patch, and the patch to the kingdoms.exe and the medieval2.exe. So we have the kingdoms.exe here, and I believe we have the medieval2 one here, so they need to be patched on the CD as well. In the mods folder you place the mod, we have Warcraft Total War, and as we can see the Medieval Total War Engine Auto Project tool is already included, same here. And unfortunately Windows 10 and other modern computers might have firewalls or antivirus programs treating this tool as a virus. So you need to go into your firewall settings or into the antivirus settings and disable, I mean you can either disable the firewall and the antivirus to make this tool work without problems, or can make an exception for the tool inside of your firewall settings or antivirus settings. This is required unless you want the firewall or the antivirus program to treat this exe file as a virus or Trojan, and place it it will place it in the trash. So this file will be deleted unless you make an exception for it in the firewall settings or antivirus settings. You can also disable the firewall and the antivirus. Okay, so that's required, otherwise this file will be removed. It's not a virus, but it's seen as a virus by modern antivirus programs because it's a tool that changes the exe files while it is running of Medieval 2. And such tools are seen as viruses or Trojans by modern modern computer security. Okay, so modern security is causing a lot of trouble for modders because certain modding tools are seen as viruses by the antiviruses or firewalls. Okay, So when you have made sure it works, you should also, if you haven't done it for other models already, disable the UAC or user account control. You can do that by going to the control panel and finding the user account control area somewhere and then disable it, because otherwise that will also interfere with mods and prevent mods from working properly. So when you have this done, then the mod should work perfectly fine on the CD version. You just click on the CD will work on both Windows 7 and on Windows 10. You right click here and click run as administrator, and then you have all of this already selected. Just leave it as it is. You can change this stuff, religion limit and chillers limit, etc., if you are a modder and know what you're doing. But if you're not a modder, don't touch these areas because it's not required, and it's better left untouched if you don't know what you're doing. So in the upload, I don't know if these are the if only Berserk's fix and Creatures fix are selected. I might have other options selected too. So for example, if there are more than these two selected, then make sure to deselect these three so that only the Berserk's fix and the Creatures fix are selected, because the Berserk's fix will fix the crash that happens in battle whenever a unit using the Berserk mental state enters reaches the enemy in battle. In the vanilla game, Medieval Total War game, there were some leftovers from Rome Total War, because Rome Total War and Medieval Total War Kingdoms are using the same engine, but Medieval Total War had more features and updated graphics and such, but certain features from Rome Total War were not included, or they were partly included. For example, the Berserk mental state in use in Barbarian Invasion maybe. So you could add the Berserk mental state to units in Medieval 2, but when they reach the enemy in battle, the game will crash because the animations for the Berserkers weren't moved over from Rome to Medieval 2. This tool fixed that, so I've enabled that. So in Warcraft Total War, I believe it's the Horde and Dark Horde Blade Masters that are using it, and the Troll Slayers of the Kingdom of Stromgarde. So if you don't want those units to crash in battle when they reach enemies, you need to have this selected. And then the Creatures fix, the main reason I installed the Medieval Total War Engine Overhaul Project Tool, or M2TWEOP-tool, was because this mod, Warcraft Total War, is using a bunch of creatures like scorpions, snapdragons, fellhounds, etc. And it's also using giants like the Ancients of War, the sea giants, and such. And then it's also using giant dragons, and all of those units on Windows 10 computers would crash a few moments after the camera centers on them. So you needed this tool to fix that, because the Creatures fix is fixing the skeleton animations of or skeletons of all the elephant based units. So giants, creatures and such, they are based on elephants from the vanilla game, but using in many cases unique new animations from Warhammer Beginning of the End Times. And we needed this tool to fix the skeleton, otherwise the units would crash almost immediately upon starting a battle, as soon as you have the camera on them on Windows 10 computers. So I had to deactivate or disable or remove all the giants, creatures and dragons from this mod in the campaign, because it crashed all the time for people using Windows 10, and today most people are using Windows 10 and not Windows 7. On Windows 7, I believe that creatures like the snapdragons, fellhounds, etc., they worked fine, and many giants and giant dragons worked fine, but I believe they could still crash if there were too many. Some of them, if in a full stack, would crash, like the ancient dragon turtles would crash seconds after starting a battle. But with this tool, they will never crash. None of the giants and creatures will crash. So these two options are necessary. That's the reason I added this tool to this mod. But the other options, unlock console command, spawn army fix, new family tree, they are not necessary. Deactivate them and click apply changes to save. Then the next time you start the tool, they will be deactivated from the start. Because if you have too many options, like if you have all of these options enabled, then you may experience heavy lag in battles, especially as the Night Elves and such. Yeah, you tried a battle with the Night Elves versus the Legion. It lagged so much that you couldn't really enjoy it. But when I deactivated these then and applied the changes, then it didn't lag at all. So my advice is not to use too many of these options. And then when you start the game with the CD using the tool, don't click here and start vanilla. Vanilla means the original game, Medieval Total War Kingdom. So if you click here, you start the original game. Click on start mod or run mod here. Then you will start the mod. So that's with the CD version. It should work fine as long as you have made an exception for this exe file in the firewall or antivirus program, or if you have disabled those so that they won't remove the file. Then you should be able to start it when you click start mod. But with the Steam version it might be a little more complicated. So with Steam you have the game in Steam, Steam apps, common, Medieval Total War, and here you need to do what I said about copying the exe file and renaming it to Kingdoms. So you have two such files and you need to use the 4GB patch as I said, and that's done. It's not enough. You will also need to do a final step. So in the article I have a picture, right click on this and then open a new tab. Then you will get a bigger view here. So what you need to do is, you need to right click on the medieval2.exe and the kingdoms.exe. You can start with the medieval2.exe. Then you will, if you right click on it, you go to medieval2, right click on the medieval2.exe and then you click on properties here, the one at the bottom. And then you go to compatibility. And it looks a little different here because I'm on a Windows 7 computer. But you go to this view, compatibility, and you get this view. But this is in Russian, unfortunately, because the tool was made by Russian modders and coders, etc. But programmers and such. But anyway, you right-click on the .exe, and then you click on properties, and then compatibility, and you get this screen on Windows 10. And then you check this box, and then you click here, and then you get to this screen where you check this box as well, and then you click OK, and you're done. So this will fix an issue, because on Windows 10 you could start a game using the tool after you have done the same stuff you did on for the CD, but then the screen would be just a tiny little box in the corner. In one of the corners, I don't know which one because I haven't had the issue myself, I just heard about it. So by doing that stuff I just showed you, you will get the full screen when you start the game and not just the tiny corner. But you need to do it to the medieval2.exe and then to the kingdoms.exe, and then you need to go to mods and VTV. So you need to place the VTV folder, the mod folder here, go here. And of course this file will be removed if you haven't disabled the firewall or antivirus or made an exception, so you need to do that first. But when you have the tool .exe here, the M2TWEOP tool, you need to right click on it, click on properties, compatibility, and then you need to do the same thing for this file. Then when you start it, click on run as an administrator, run as an administrator, I meant. Okay, just leave these as they are, don't change these, and if there are any more options selected than these two, then deselect them and click apply changes. You need to click apply changes to save, and then start the mod. And when you start the mod, or run the mod, you will get this screen. So we can see the tool text there, but it's kind of hidden because of this stuff. Okay, so we have Warcraft Total War here. I don't want to say anything more.